Davao, an industrialized city blessed with nature's bounty. Locals value their downtime from the hustle and bustle of city life, and the land is lush with flora and fauna. When you look around, you'll see the fruits of Mother Nature everywhere you go, and that includes the sea. Davao Gulf is teeming with wildlife. And what the Gulf truly gives access to the Davaoenos is their favorite fish, the yellowfin tuna. And that's what we'll be chasing today on Chasing Flavors. Davao was once made up of many indigenous groups, all benefiting from the blessings of land and sea. The Davaoenos has always had the foresight to preserve tradition while being open to progress. And that's why in the 1970s, the Davao Museum was established. The museum's mission is to preserve Davao culture, especially that of the many tribes of Davao, such as the Bogobo, who still live along the coastline of the Davao Gulf. And today, I'm meeting up with my friends Carlo Calma Lorenzana and Carmina Del Rosario, who are also advocates in promoting Davao, especially its food industry.
So how was your tour of the Davao Museum?
For a small museum, I learned a lot. You know, I learned about the original 11 indigenous groups that settled here. And very, very impressive.
Correct. It's a really amazing museum.
It's a good way of introducing oneself to the culture of Davao.
We're excited to have you here and to tour you and your tummy around Davao. So the first stop, Carlo will take you to Marina Tuna, and then I will take you to an exciting place called Yellowfin.
Let's go.
The first thing that came up to my mind when I learned that I was going to Davao was tuna. Ever since I've known about Davao, from the first time I went to Davao some 20 years ago, it was already tuna that was their iconic dish.
Hi, Doming. I'm sure you remember she's Chef Claude.
Yes, I interviewed you 2 years ago.
Wow, it's nice to be acquainted with you again. And
sure.
Try your, what is it? 10 ways of serving tuna?
10 way tuna. Yeah.
Lahat ng mga hindi taga Davao, dinadala talaga dito.
So, mas ano to?
This is one of the first stops.
First stop.
Most of the time, if not 90% of the time. Kasi malapit sa airport.
And every part of the fish is utilized. What is your best seller here?
Actually, it's the tuna kinilaw.
Locals and foreigners alike eat this?
Yeah, sure, but most of the local, they prefer the kinilaw.
Very fresh, it's almost like sashimi.
Yeah, actually, we use the same fish from the first class sashimi also. For the sashimi and the kinilaw, it's the same.
Domingo, tell me, how did you start in the tuna industry or tuna restaurant?
My father was the pioneer of the tuna industry.
Here in Davao?
In Davao and in Gensan also.
Yeah, because when we talk about tuna, it's just Davao and Gensan.
Yeah, those two. Yeah, but actually, tuna my fishing started here in Davao, long time ago by the Japanese, before the war.
Before World War II?
Yes. They were here actually on the banana industry. They were planting banana here.
Also
and banana and a baka.
Yeah. And it happened that most of the Japanese were from Okinawa. Mm-hmm. And they really excel in tuna fishing.
Oh, so they fished tuna for their own consumption?
Yeah, for local consumption.
Not to export back to
Japan? No, at that time it's only for local consumption.
Yeah, and then you and your father actually started the exportation of...
exportation of the tuna.
To Japan?
To Japan, both for frozen tuna, for canning, and for sashimi.
And sashimi?
This is the one, that's what you're eating now.
Yeah, and what year was that?
1970s, early 70s. We have to extract the fish from all over. From Jose Santos, from even Surigao. This is the center. Davao is the center where we fly the tuna out from Davao to Japan.
What is this?
This is sigang.
Sinigang.
Sinigang.
Yeah, tuna. Oh, look at that. Puppy eye and the eyeball. In our culture, Filipino and Chinese, the head is the most important part, right? It's reserved to the padre de familia or the special guest.
Yeah.
So I think I'm the special guest here.
Of course.
The tenway tuna starts from the head, the tuna head. This is the
tuna head, the sinigang.
Then we follow with the kinilaw.
Kinilaw?
The kinilaw, and then the sashimi.
This is the loin part.
The loin part. And we have the tuna belly.
The belly, so it's grilled.
Yeah, grilled. The tuna buntot, this is the deep fried.
The tail is different.
Parang lechon kawali.
Lechon kawali, yeah. Crispy pata.
Yeah.
Then it looks more of the... Yeah, so crispy skin.
Yeah.
And then...
Okay, then we have the kare-kare.
Kare-kare, what part of the...
It's also the tail.
Also the tail.
Oh, the tail.
Oh, yeah, the skin, that's the collagen, di ba? Parang sa...
Oh, yeah, ito yung may collagen. The tuna... Bagaybay.
Bagaybay is the...
Sperm sac.
So that's the in-between, the inside.
And this is my particular favorite, bihod.
Bihod would be the caviar.
Let me serve you some...
Sige. Tingnan natin what you're talking about here.
Ang favorite ko dito, parang durian to eh. Marami mga singit-singit.
Sarap nga, nambot nung loob. Crispy on the edges.
Diba, people always think Jensan.
Jensan is known as the... Is it known now as the tuna capital?
Well, the sourcing.
That's the sourcing,
yes.
But when you think of Davao, it's the tuna as a cook dish.
Yes.
Yeah. And so many ways.
It's a place where you can really enjoy tuna.
Tuna in so many
ways. At its best. In Davao.
Yeah. This goes by the mouth-to-tail thing that's going on worldwide by using every part of the animal, or fish in this case, and everything in between.